driving through Cuyahoga Valley National Park. Got a train going by. This here is Cuyahoga Valley National Forest headquarters. Each division gets its own little building. Pretty cool. And you got the headquarters parking right here. Boston Mills Road is the road you turn on to find these waterfalls. Alright, let this bad boy begin. It is so windy outside right now. Holy crap, is it windy out. Like, wow. Here, the trail merges with the Buckeye Trail and the Janet Trail. But we are going to the Blue Hen Falls Trail. So we're going this way. Good thing the river's low. Oh shit, almost fell. Look at them trees. Just had to jump up some shit that didn't think I was gonna make it. I'll show you on the way back, it was pretty sketchy. A lot of people like to walk the river. Not me. I'm gonna take the trail so that way I can show you which way to go. But you can walk the river if you want. Many people do it. It's actually probably easier. You don't have to climb over all this crazy obstacle courses and stuff. I mean, think about it. If you walk the river, you don't have to come down this, which is pretty darn sketchy, if I must say so. I'll be right back. I mean, I gotta walk down this. Now we're gonna go downhill. On the way up, before we go back to the other waterfall, I'm gonna go up that area up there and show you where the ski resort is. You climb up there and you walk up that pathway, the one that goes up through there. But right now, I wanna go this way, so we can go down there. Kids are crazy.
You shooting your picture for him? Oh yeah, yeah.
No. Right over there, my favorite place to sit and chill. where this big rock is, take this little dirt way path right here. Gotta be careful though, because it's hard to tell. It's a little sketchy drop right there. And this trail is very dangerous. If you can't tell, it's 100 foot drop. It ain't no more than 4 foot wide with big roots. This is not a trail right here I would bring little kids on. I mean, one false move and, well, it ain't gonna be good. There is a steep hill when you get up here too. One thing I could say, I haven't found any trash. Oh my god. It's like straight fucking up. It's just as bad as my property in the first 100 yards. Look at that. That's straight down. Oh my god. And there's that area I drove past earlier. And like I said, right up here at the top of the hill. It's a nice little area to come up here and, you know, eat your lunch and peace and quiet away from everybody. Not a lot of people know about this section. It's pretty cool though. Branywine Snow Resort, Ski Resort. And these are the ski lifts and all that stuff. Walking down the river is beautiful. See these old walls from where the old railroad used to come through here and the old carriage roads and stuff. This is part of one of the old carriage roads. Little purple flower. now we're almost out the park. You could hike this whole thing in an hour. Literally, you could hike this whole park in an hour. It's not that big, not that complex. Half an hour to get down, half an hour to get back. Probably take 2.5 hours the whole trip, because you're going to be hanging out at each waterfall. Man, I swear to God, I hope I'm not like trapped in here. People are coming up in here crazy with these cars. Oh, no, 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 no. Good way to end off a hike. Chocolate chip ice cream. From Strickland's. Best place to get ice cream in the world. Gotta go to Strickland's.